Josephine Aguilar of University of Santo Tomas. She's on the line now. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, TJ.
Good to hear from you again, ma'am.
Yes.
Happy New Year to you. Well, thanks for joining us. And, you know, I hope you saw some bits of the show, of this internet show that we were showing. And we'd like to ask your opinion about it. What was your original reaction as to what's going on and what's being shown and perceived to be, so allegedly, reality of what happens in these bars?
Okay. What has been... I saw that last night on television.
Okay.
And what I saw was basically the effect of technology to women nowadays. It seems though that they themselves created a paradigm shift as to how they should handle themselves. And even if you ask them why do they do it, they will tell you that, you know, it is just nothing. So the change happens to be on their values. So technology has affected their values and their outlook in life.
Professor, good afternoon. Lexi Schultz here.
Yes, Lexi.
Do you feel, ma'am, that this would be their way of getting perhaps their 15 minutes of fame? Because it seems to be now that everyone wants to be famous in whatever way that can that they can come by.
Yeah, from the point of view of sociology, surely you become famous because what you did was a deviation from what is expected of you. So you create a controversy, and controversy makes you famous. So, well, some people would use that as an avenue to be famous.
Right.
And it is, as I've said, it is a deviation.
Ma'am, how much do you think of a factor in this is alcohol, and how much the youth drink today, and how they let loose and really just party when they're in these kinds of clubs that apparently seem to be conducive to just let all inhibitions go?
You see, it seems though that they forgot the term limitation. They should know their limitations. You know, they have in the first place, they should know what they're talking about. They are aware of what they're doing. And they also know as to how much they should drink. But going beyond the limitations can create something unexpected. Unexpected of what we should do when we drink. That is why social drinking is still advisable.
Well, ma'am, in terms of the producer and the host, they were interviewed, obviously, and the host justified saying that he looks like a regular Joe or the ordinary man, and he wanted to be a role model of sorts to people who do look similar to him and say that you can still nab the chicks. I mean, do you think that's a fair justification at all?
I don't think so. I don't think so. What he did was a sweeping statement, no? That... you know, a role model with that kind. It seems so that the producer has to think of propriety. In other words, it seems so that he does not understand what propriety means.
And in terms of the actual producer, he was saying that he didn't really break any laws because in terms of MTRCB, I don't think they have jurisdiction over anything that's shown on the internet, unfortunately.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Yeah, yes. That is what we should suggest to MTRCB, because it seems though that the internet, it is true that they did not violate anything because the internet is not part of the censorship, right? There is no censorship in the internet. But if other countries can do censorship, why can't we? See, because in some countries like China, there is such a thing as what we call gatekeeping. So why not in our country?
Well, there were attempts to do that, some form of that with the cyber crime prevention law, professor, and You know, with regard to that, what was what were the sentiments of your students and the youth that you were interacting with? Obviously, today's youth is very much active online. How are they feeling with regards to any form of censorship online?
Censorship online. You know, I am in a very conservative university,
right.
Mm-hmm. And majority of our students here are very traditional.
Mm-hmm.
Even if you see them, you see them as so modern and all, but it seems that their concept of what is right and wrong has not been tainted,
mm-hmm.
you know, has not been totally tainted.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems though that they react so much.
Mm-hmm.
Reaction of asking so many whys.
Mm-hmm.
That is why if you will ask them, they will tell you there has to be censorship.
Mm-hmm. All right. I want to thank you for joining us on the line and giving
anytime.
Us your thoughts, Professor Josephine AGUILAR-PLACIDO. Thank you, ma'am,
anytime.
So much.
Thank you.